Guess who's back and has glasses? This guy. I have started actually seeing a therapist. Now, this video is going to be about how I found the therapist, why I started seeing therapy, what I expected, what I've gotten out of it so far, and then my final thoughts on it overall. Before we get into it, I just want to let you guys know that I am trying to get back into this full time. Full time, but I mean consistent schedule again. I'm gonna try to stream as much as I can again. I've gone through one of those ruts, and I'll talk about that later in the video here, but I made a few bad decisions, went on a crazy ass career path, and decided that it was definitely not for me, and that I really need to concentrate on myself, and that's what I'm doing. So I'm starting out by making this video, sharing with you guys my experience with therapy. I have gone to two therapy sessions so far. The first one was more of an introductory session where I explained what I knew about myself, what problems I already knew I had, what I wanted out of the therapy sessions, what I expected, and just kind of got to get to know the therapist as well, just to know what they do. And then there wasn't really much with that. Basically, I went in there thinking, okay, I really don't know what to expect. I know the stigmas against therapy. I know my own stigmas against therapy, but I'm going to go in with an open mind and see what happens. I went out of that first session excited and happy, just generally relieved that I feel like it's going to work. Because when I went in there, I explained to the therapist, I suffer from anxiety, depression. Because of those two, I'll get very depressed and worried about my career and my life. So I'll get desperate and make a really stupid decision, and then that causes these ruts and then, inconsistencies in my channels and stuff. A lot to me. So off the bat, there's okay, so you're anxious about time. You don't want to waste your time, and so we kind of went off in there, and I explained how I have an issues. I get very defensive. I mean, when I get blamed for things I feel like I didn't do. So those are the things I explained to them, and then she was like, okay, cool, she didn't say cool, but said, okay, that seems like you have some, things in your past that have shaped you to who you are today, and kind of causes you to do that, maybe because you're worried that you won't become who you want to be, so you just try desperately anywhere to get you into a position that will help you get to where you want to be, and stuff like that. So little bit tidbits here and there, but it was really more introductory. And I walked out of there thinking, okay, well, obviously, I feel confident that she knows what she's doing. I feel confident in that she can help me. And we've already, right off the bat, we already figured out some issues that I was having. So it's great. Now, in the second session, we dived more into, for example, my ruts. So how that really works is it'll be consistent. It'll be at least once a month. I'll get into a three-day rut where I get really depressed, anxious, and desperate. I feel like my career is going nowhere. I feel like I'm not doing enough. And then I just won't do anything. And then I'll get really desperate and I'll try to jump to something you guys know the flings I have where I try to go competitive with Overwatch or competitive with Hearthstone. Or, do this or do that. I think I'll do it. And then I realize that I hate it and I don't really want to do it. And then I get into another rut and then I do something else stupid and so on and so on and so on. Now, we kind of delved into that, and really because we couldn't find the exact reason as to why that is or why I do that, but we figured out that I definitely need to just sit down and figure out what I really want to do with myself and just stick with it. And that's basically what I'm doing right now. I mean, I'm going back to what I know I love, what I really know I love, and I'm just going to stick with it. Hopefully. I said that three or four times so far, so yeah. But then we figured out that I am a... Oh, fuck, huh? Give me a sec to Google this. Okay, I have no idea what this thing is called, but basically I laugh when I get angry or annoyed. I become very sarcastic or very humorous in a sense. A lot of the stories I can recount when I get into fights or something like that, I'll actually start laughing manically. Manically? I can't even English. The best example I can think of is think of the Joker on a very, 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 very calm down level. But when he gets angry or annoyed, stuff like that, or when he's on one of his giant killing sprees, he's laughing and he's generally humorous and sarcastic. So that's me again, way, he's up here, I'm way down here. Like, you can't even see my hands. Like, whoop. But I fucking cannot remember what that's called. But we figured out, you know, that's me, because I was honking, I was recounting some things about my dad, and I was laughing. And I was pointing out, like, you know, this potion and that potion, and I was laughing because that's just what I do, and I guess that's how I cope with my anger, and that I just kind of, like, I try to put it in a funny way, and it helps, obviously. So we also figured out that, you know, I rather be passive aggressive when dealing with confrontation rather than being upfront, and that's a very bad thing. So we went over a few ways to fix that, like, stop, think before I say something sarcastic, and think, you know, probably just better to just say it up front when I'm annoyed with somebody and just be like, hey, I'm not, like, mad at you, or I don't hate you, I'm just annoyed by this one thing that you did, can we talk about it? And then rather than being like, so you know that one time that you, like, obviously what's gonna start an argument? Passive aggressiveness or being upfront? Passive aggressiveness, because they're gonna get mad at me for being passive aggressive. So the second session went really well. So, you know, we figured out that I am the stoned version of the Joker, you know, if you smoke weed. I am passive aggressive, and that, what was the other thing we found out? I already forgot. This is what happens when you only get 3 hours of sleep. You know, I felt like the second session went really well. We made progress. I felt more confident in the therapist himself, and I felt like I was actually going to be able to get something out of this. I felt even more motivated to make a change in my life, like, by the second session. That's crazy. And I think it went really, also really well, because the therapist himself was really suited for me. And I want to get into how I found the therapist here in just a minute, but I wanted to leave it with this. Like, there's a lot of stigma. Or I want to end this with this. This, I want to end this with this. That is a sentence, I swear. There's a lot of stigma against therapy. There's a lot of stigma against, you know, are they helpful? Are they a waste of time? All they do is just say, what are you feeling? Like, no, that's actually complete bullshit. Out of the two sessions, she actually never said that. She never said to me once, what are you feeling right now? Or anything. She asked how I felt sometimes during certain scenarios, but never, like, how are you feeling? Like, that eight stereotypical sentence? No, never like that. I actually didn't lay down on a couch either. I sat in a chair, but I'm assuming it's, like, depending on the therapist. And the payment. And I'm going to get into that a little bit later, but, like, a lot of people think therapists are super expensive, but they're not, actually. If you think about it, I go bi-weekly, and that was by my choice. The therapist suggested that I go weekly, but I said bi-weekly, and I pay $50 a week. And that's, normally it's $70, but my insurance covers part of it, so I can just co-pay 50, which is great. And, so it's therapy is actually a lot different than what you think it is. And if you've ever been like me, where you've never been to a therapist and you're very skeptical about it and you don't really think it'll help, shut the fuck up. It will. It will. Trust me. I was the same thing. I literally argued with my girlfriend about it and my mom. Like, I just told them straight up, like, I don't want to see a therapist. It's not going to fucking help. You know, they're just going to talk to me. I'm going to talk to them and nothing's going to get fucking done, because I don't even know my own problems. I don't even know why I'm angry. And now I kind of do. So, because we talked about it. So it's like, duh. Yeah, it will really work. Trust me. And then, like, of course, the next thing will come up is like, well, how do I find a therapist? What do I do? What do I look for? Well, actually, there's people that will do that for you. And sort of the part of the reason I made this video was because someone that works with this company, and Eric, Truth and Requiem. Basically, what happens, we went to a panel called Anxiety Gaming, and it's a company, or not a non-profit, I really should say. And we went to the panel, they talked about what they did, and I met Eric, who became like a best friend. He was an awesome guy, love him to death. And he works for them, and, you know, basically what they do, I was trying to describe who Eric was so nobody was confused, but basically what they do is they find therapists for people, and they don't just, like, Google search, okay, here's one like 50 minutes away from you. Like, no, they'll find them, they'll call them, they'll, you know, interview them in a way, they'll try to figure out if they're a good match, because you fill out a form kind of, you know, describing what you know you have, like, you know, if you have any, like, actual conditions, like, you know, so depression, anxiety, bipolar, you know, PTSD, so on and so forth. And then they'll kind of talk to you a little bit more about it, try to figure out, what's best for you, see what you want out of the therapist. Like, do you want someone that will give you instructions? Do you want someone that will kind of more guide you along, a little more passive? And then they'll go out and they'll find someone like that. And then they'll, if they feel like it's not a good fit, a really funny story, the owner told a story at the panel, and basically they called this therapist and he kind of blew him off. And they're like, that was weird, right? He just blew him off. He's like, yeah, whatever, just come in and we'll do it. And then they had one of their female workers call in, and then he immediately was very interested in what she had to say. And that was an immediate red flag. Like, obviously, duh, like that dude is probably more interested in having female patients, which is not a good thing. I mean, come on, if you can't figure that one out, then I'm done. I'm done with this world. So, they do stuff like that. They really try to figure out, A, is it a good therapist? B, is it the right therapist for you? And then they'll get you in contact with them and they'll help you set up everything. And then the next thing obviously comes with payment. And this is something I was really surprised about. They'll actually help you pay for it. If you don't have insurance, like they'll set up a copay with you. So they'll pay part of it and then you'll pay the rest of it. Now, if you can't pay it at all, I'm not really sure the exact rules to this, so don't quote me on this, but I believe there are options for you where they'll pay for it. Like, if you can prove that you have absolutely no way to pay for it, they'll pay for it. And then, like, if you want to do a copay, you'll just show them how much you make, how much your bills are, and then they'll, find a good price for you. So it's really great. It's like, and it's a great service. You don't have to pay for it, obviously. You just go to their website, you sign up, and that's it. They get in contact with you via email to talk to you, and they'll help you find a therapist. And it takes basically the hardest part of therapy out of the picture, which is finding the right fucking therapist and then paying for it. So I thought it was great. Now, of course, all the links to them are gonna be in the description below. I'm gonna give you the website so you can go check them out. They have a Discord server, which is really great. It's almost like a little, it's like a community where you can go in, you can find people who play maybe the same games as you. If you play World of Warcraft, they're gonna love you because that's actually where they started. They started as a clan or something. I forgot what it's called in World of Warcraft, but it was basically a clan that did that. They were there, just you come in, you join, and they were like therapists almost. They just let you talk and rant and stuff like that. Now that's kind of what their Discord is as well. You can find people to talk to, find people to play games with, and it's great. And I think what they're doing is amazing. I love it. Yeah, that's all I have to say about that. That's my therapy. I'm gonna go into more about what we discuss as the therapy sessions go on. I might dive into a little bit more. I left out a few details of things that we talked about just because they're a little up there. Not really sure if they're YouTube friendly, but YouTube's currency. I don't even know if this is YouTube considered YouTube friendly, but we'll make more videos as we go on about that, and then of course I'll try to make other videos as well. Obviously, I'm gonna try to make as much as I can, as quickly as I can, but also making quality content because that's what I love doing. I love making YouTube videos. I love talking. This is my favorite thing to do. And then of course I'm gonna be streaming. Make sure to check out my Twitch, twitch.tv/Wolfgang_Duopas. You'll go there, you'll hit the follow button, and then you wait for me to go live. I normally go live around, I want to say like 10 a.m. Central time. That's when because I work overnight, so I have to stream in the morning. So make sure to check me out. I play Overwatch, Rainbow Six Siege, Call of Duty, Hearthstone. I mean, come on, I'm like I do everything. If you have an extra like copy of PUBG, I would love you if you can give that to me because I really want it, but I can't afford it because money is non-existent. So well, with that said, I just want to thank you guys for watching this entire video. If you have, holy shit, thank you for kind of sticking through my rambling. I am running on like 3 hours of sleep, so my brain keeps losing its train of thought. There's the thing. And I'm burping because of all the. Shut up! My phone wants to tell me there's a message for me. All right, well, with that said, again, like I said, losing my train of thought here. I guess we'll see you guys next time. If you guys want to talk more about therapy or anything like that, make sure comment down below, or you can hit me up on Twitter at Wolfgang_Lupos. Hit me up on my Twitch. When I'm streaming, I am 100% to your guys' attention or at your guys' disposal. I pay attention so much with chat. I'm very conversive in my Twitch chat, so you guys can chat with me there. And yeah, I really don't know how to do this outro. I wanted to change my outro, but really don't know what to do, so I didn't think about this. Probably should have done that first. Awkward. All right, well, until next time, wish love yourselves and love life, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Deuces. Deuces. Oh, that's the hashtag thing. That what's her name? Which is this, right? Who's that? Who's it? That chick? She's like fucking hilarious. Shit, I forgot. All right, I'll catch you guys later.